Cootamundra, New South Wales. Home of the Wiradjuri people. You know, to the Wiradjuris, Cootamundra meant turtle. But what would First Nations people call this place today? This place where muscle cars thunder down an airport runway. How would they describe rev heads, barbecues, burnouts, Sydney versus Melbourne, Greek versus Italian, Mustang versus Monaro? Is there an Indigenous word for place where blokes meet for 3 days to the sound of screaming engines, to smoke their tyres and tell their stories? Well, there's already a word. COOTA400. Go, COOTA400!
Hey team, COOTA400 back in town. Can't wait to do this all again. Can't believe we're all back after all the bad weather and everything else, but hey, look at all this. This is looking fantastic. We have a record crowd of about 125 cars, and they are looking all amazing. We'd love to thank the town of Cootamundra for helping us do this again. We love the town and we're glad to be back. Again, thank you gentlemen, to all the lovely people that have turned up to this event. Wow, what an event. Go COOTA400, go guys. Yeehaw.
XYGT. This is my fourth COOTA in a row. It's running a 440 Windsor Procharge. I'm just happy to be part of the event. It's always good fun. I ran 147 mile last year. If I get the 150, I'll be wrapped. We're racing against mates, racing against the Melbourne boys. They're bringing it this year. It's all about having fun, to be quite honest. Yeah. It's got around 1200 at the tyre, and it's running a manual, so it's running a Jerrycan. I think we just keep it safe on top of everything else. We all have fun, and it's just a great event. And I'd like to thank Chris as well for organising this event. It's a lot of effort, and without him, we wouldn't be doing this event. So, yeah, no, it's great stuff. Thanks.
Keep it straight. I know there's going to be gaps here, but make it line up there.
Where the fuck's that stick?
Hi team, how are you going? I'd like to thank everyone from Cootamundra for letting us have this little car show. The council's provided us a little bit of a spot here so we can have a little show here at Cootamundra. Look how lovely it is. The locals have turned up even though it's starting to rain. Great turnout. Thank you Cootamundra, thank you town for letting us use your town once again.
It's probably one of the best things Coota's had in a long, long time, yeah. They've been coming for a few years and it's just getting bigger and bigger. It's so good for the town, like money-wise. Just the people that come to town, they spend up big in town, buy everything local. It's awesome.
How are we going, people? Glad to see you here. This is a really good promotion for the town. And the small country towns at the moment, after COVID, they really need to get back. And get back into going places and doing things, and we're very appreciative of all the cars and the people here and what they'll spend in the town.
Do you own a car that's here? Or?
Yes, I do, that white Falcon over there. I'm a local, so.
And were you here last year?
Yeah, I came watch the drags last year.
Yeah, how'd it go?
Yeah, it was good watching them, yep.
Yeah, and how do you think it's going to go this year?
I reckon it'll go good. There's a good turnout of cars this year, so it'll be really good.
You're not racing yourself, though?
No.
Yeah, I'm coming there tomorrow. I'm going to watch it.
Yeah.
Heckers.
Yeah, it's
pretty heckers, G. Your
body.
Mad as G.
Go Coota! Woohoo! Yo yo!
Here today at the Coota 400, day one, Friday. It's clearing up. It looks a bit overcasty, but everyone's here today. It's looking great. We're going to give it a good shot and go Coota 400.
roll through. It's amazing.
So, I just want everyone that's got a wristband and the car is scrutinized, park it inside just in front of the bouncers and all that area. Spread yourselves out. No one park in the middle. You're not special. Spread yourselves out because before you know it, we're not going to have any room. Hey guys, thanks for coming. Look, I'm sorry about the delay, but we're going to hopefully get through today. what we're going to do, we're going to let you guys go through quickly, the top like 10 and 10. So you're going to go down, same rules, see Nick, Nick will send you down. Oh, the bus will be up there shortly. You're going to go to the start line where Troy is.
So let's just get this track dry, down the right lane. Marshall will be down there, hold the group of 10, they'll send you back, back up the left lane. Don't be a dickhead in the left lane coming back because you're coming towards people.
Yeah.
And mate, it's Coota, we know how it all runs, let's just go and have some fun.
So how'd you go?
Not too bad considering the conditions. Peeled off at 1480 something, so a lot of wheel spin, and I think I backed off before the end as well, so got through it, so that was the main thing.
So leave your cars here, let's go. Just leave them here.
B turbo, 323 wagon, C4 with a 9-inch. It's a beast. Bought it about 3 weeks ago. One of my good mates built it from the ground up. I've always liked the car. I've always had a bit of a fancy for it, and come up for grabs and I took it off his hands. It's not hard to drive, it's just, it's got that much power. The RSN kicks out, so I've got to learn what the RSN does before I give it too much. But it's definitely different to the V8s. I've got V8s at home and this is just so much fun. Oh, I know all the mixing, how to pre-mix it all, and it's running full on E85, so all that sort of stuff, but it's just complete different car to a V8.
So it's running a 434 small block, power glide, full flow to 90. Run the hit of nitrous as well. Been running for the last 10 years. That's it, come up to Coota, have a bit of fun with the boys, and that's it. Mainly been a street car, and that's it. It's a HG 1970, in wearing, $1,800 for 10 years ago, which you wouldn't even probably get a bonnet for it nowadays, but yeah, just escalated from there.
Yeah, it's good for the business here in Cootamundra because, you know, they always, like today, we got a lot of booking, about 30 bookings for Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And they all, every time, every year, when there's the racing cars, they come here at the Central Hotel. And I do appreciate, you know, them coming every time. Yeah, I do sell a lot of T-bones whenever they come, you know, and they love the steak. And the bangers and mash, you know, Australian food.
Yeah, so we've got a great bunch of cars here. I'm really proud of all the boys and their attitude. Could be better, but you know, we're hoping the weather turns around and get some cars on the track and have some fun. But I reckon a couple hours is good to go.
Yeah, so it's ran 8 nines before.
We're just trying to get it down this airport this weekend. It's a crate engine from Herod's Performance in Thomastown. So come from the States out of a race Mustang. And yeah, that was like the spare engine they provide as an option. If you don't get that engine, they just sell it to the market. So it goes in a Cobra Jet Mustang in the States. So straight in, all we've done is change the injectors and pulley and off you go. Been off the road for 3 years getting painted. So we did drag challenge in 2019. It was first outing. And this is its first outing after it's been painted, coming to Coota.
The best country, man, look, without the camera. Without you, this game would have been a success place.
I love coming to Cootamundra. I like sharing a room with Ino. I like keeping everyone awake.
E36 a snitzer.
Snorri Snorrington. Coming to you live from Cootamundra.
Cooter.
Yeah, it's just an XA coupe. It's just got a 351 in it, alloy heads, 4-speed, 9-inch stick. Yeah, a bit rough, but that's how I like it, you know. It's like a barn find sort of wreck, but I never painted it. I just sort of did a few little rust repairs here and there and got it registered and sort of decent running gear in it. So, you know, it goes good on a prep track. Yeah, on the 8th, I've been quite a bit of racing with it. Yeah, like I say, Gunnabarn Casino. I've been to Willow Bank in Eastern Creek with it, but it's not tech, so I usually go home after the first run.
We come here to do the Cootamundra 400 fire protection and safety and first aid. Cootamundra is basically a pretty much a farming community. A lot of broadacre farming here, and farming really props up our town. When car meets such as this come to town, it really puts a great investment into our town, and we hope you have a really good fun time here.
I just finished it 2 weeks ago, just got it ready for Coota. It's been a couple of years in the making getting it ready. It's a Barra 66-64 turbo, a little bit of head work, and a little bit of bottom end work. Nothing too serious, but I've always owned Capris. I've had a clip of Capri, I've got another one at home as well, 72 original, but I wanted one to muck around with. When I came here 4 years ago, that was it. I had to have one. There's an XA over there with a white one with a black roof. That really triggered me off. And I asked what was in that car, and that's why I took out the Chev of this one and put the Barrow in this Capri, yeah.
Spun a bit, but it was good. So, yeah, took a little pressure out of it. Got a bit too excited and too hard at the start, but we're getting into it. We'll get it sorted soon.
That's a 1600 with the SR20 turbo. That's about it. Hopefully we can give it to some of these V8 guys. Hopefully. Got electric power steer, electric heated seats. It's got it all. Never raced before. Let's see how we go.
Yeah, good. It went 11.2, 126. It's slippery off the line. But yeah, top end's all right. It's good.
After 4 years, so extremely happy. It went well, 10.7, 136. So let's see what happens.
So can you actually do a burnout in a sport?
You can, but you can break a lot of stuff too, so let's not break anything.
That Falcon with 347 Windsor in it, and I went 12.4 track.
Yeah, so 1983 VH Commodore. It's LS2, carby fed. First time racing, so we'll see what happens. It's had a fair bit of top end work from the crank up, the stock crank. And yeah, it was all built at home and first time out, so we'll see what happens. Yeah, I did a lot of it. A mate of mine built the engine. Mick Van Steenbeck built the engine. I sprayed the engine bay, had a mate help me do some welding work, panel work on the engine bay. All the other bits and pieces, my mate Adam here has helped me do a lot of mechanical stuff, suspension and other bits and pieces. But yeah, it's basically all been built at home.
Actually, yeah, I ran a 12.624, so started to move towards the end, but yeah, good fun. A bit slippery, I was expecting it maybe a touch better. Seemed grippier back after the burnout than the start line, but I'm sure it'll get better as the day goes on, so looking forward to it.
First pass, 14.5 in this. A bit wet the track, but halfway during the track it was slipping, the clutch in a bit. Hopefully go for like a 12.13 next run.
Come down from Sydney. Unfortunately, the rain's hit us the last couple of days, but hopefully to get out there again and get racing.
good. It was good. I just took it easy, but just to see the first run. This is my first time here.
BK built the motor, 363 Windsor, pump fuel, it's got a TKO 600 Tremec box, 5-speed, 9-inch, and it's run a best of 10-1-3 at 134. I've had it for 20 years and it's just developed over the time. Been looking at it for a while online and in contact with Chris, and we ended up becoming a sponsor as well through our work. We'll be sponsored Sydney Dragway as well.
Fives, 111 miles per hour. Second run, second time driving it. So, not too bad. Still trying to get used to the way it goes, man.
Yeah.
Skating all over the place, so.
Christine, I'm a local from Coota. First run, done a 14. Not real good, hopefully I'll improve on my next one. Good that we're racing.
Yeah, we went well at first time out in this new combo. So, yeah,
see how we go with the next one. Traction's still a little bit of trouble, but we should pull pedal in. I think we all do on that today, you know, considering yesterday was rain and we missed it out in the day, but it's good, very good. We'll see how we go with the next one.
Slimy, not getting enough traction. There's more heat, more cars go down there, should get more stickier.
Yeah.
Just good, strong, as soon as you hit it, you're on it, it just spins. For me, my car, it's just like the power it's got, it's not going to go down the track. Let these cars go past and we'll have a lot more dry road and a lot more better takeoff off the mark, so yeah.
Thank you.
I backed off it twice. I wasn't sure where the finish line was. But I was a bit, yeah. I put it down, I took it off, put it down. But next time I know it's the Orange Witch's hat.
We're here at Jim's Takeaway, as you can see, it's all happening here. Coota 400 is all about barbecues and cars. That's one of the
brothers too. Okay, so new car this year. Big Bird's off being restored. So we've got a factory turbo 6-cylinder ESP. End up throwing an alternator belt. And that was it. All she wrote. A $20 part was the downfall. And I bought two power steering belts and an alternator belt. And I bought the power steering belts and left the alternator belt at home. It was a great day. It was good that we all waited, hung out, and it was an awesome day in the end. Especially the state of origin. And thank Christ, we took them out. The two fastest New South Wales cars. Yeah, the two fastest Victorian cars. They can say whatever they like. We won.
And Coota 400.
Yeah.
Enjoy the octopus, boys. Fred, come here, buddy.
Coota 400, yeah!
Coota 400, yeah! Mm-hmm.